This is one powerful sermon by Apostle Joshua Selman, and I believe every Christian need to watch this. I've watched this over and over again, and I've been blessed by this message. Watching it also, you also receive your blessing. So watch prayerfully.
There is nothing that is new under the sun. There are people who started from ground and God lifted them up. There are people in ministry, there are people in business, there are people in career. Listen to me, gentlemen and ladies, believers, people of God, the body of Christ, God is speaking to us. Whenever you go through situations that look challenging, that is not the time to run away from scripture. That is the time to stay true to the word of God. Psalms 119 verse 28. Psalms 119 and verse 28. Shilanos kati branda kazuzia takata. It says, my soul melted for heaviness. Strengthen thou me according unto thy word. My soul is melting, O God, overwhelmed by the challenges and the vicissitudes of life, not knowing where to go, left or right, not knowing how to manage my life in light of all of these things. When you look at the things happening across our nation, Africa, these things look discouraging. It looks like you should just run away, and people are committing suicide, people are swallowing all kinds of things to just die in their sleep. It says, my soul melted for heaviness. Strengthen thou me according unto thy word. The word of God is a comforter, and the word of God is a strengthener. Because you see, the dynamics is this: the power of God only follows what he says. If God has not said it, it is illegal for his power to come to the scene. So the word of God is a compendium of what he has said. When you find what he has said, you can be sure his power is following what he has said. Are we together? Genesis chapter 21 from verse 1 and 2, the Bible says, and the Lord visited Sarah as he had said, and the Lord did unto Sarah as he has spoken. If he says it, if he speaks it, he will do it. For Sarah conceived, that is a testimony, and bare Abraham a son in his old age. It says, at the set time which God had spoken. So you need to draw strength from scripture. Scriptures like, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, the Bible says, I fear no evil. Why? For thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me, he says. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies, that you anoint my head with oil and my cup runs over. The Lord is my light and my salvation, of whom shall I be afraid of? These are scriptures that must comfort you at these times. If it's a bereavement, you must comfort yourself that the Bible says one day there will be the sound of the archangel, and that those who are dead in Christ will arise first, and we who are alive and remain where? In him. We will be caught to meet them in the air, and then happily after, rejoicing with Jesus. It says, I know my Redeemer liveth. Let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Let the depressed say, I am encouraged and strengthened by the power of God. Most believers are not students of scripture. And so when these seasons come, there is no legitimate way to draw strength. In fact, for most people, they do not know how to draw strength from scripture. At best, they draw strength from, respectfully speaking, maybe movies or visitations from people. But most believers do not know how to sit down with the word and draw strength from it. You can draw strength from the word. Ezekiel chapter 2 and verse 1 and 2. The Bible says, he said unto me, son of man, stand up upon your feet and I will speak unto thee. And the Bible says he did not have that strength, but from that word the Spirit entered into me when he spake unto me and set me upon my feet, that I heard him that spake unto me. You must learn to draw strength from scripture. What do you do to remain an overcomer during the times of adversity, during the times where things look unpleasant?